What is up, Vikings fans? Welcome back to the Minnesota Vikings podcast. And today we have a special guest. It's Jaleel Johnson of the Vikings defensive line. What's going on, Jaleel?
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Doing well, and I think you're doing pretty well after a successful win at Lambeau Field. It's your fourth season with the Minnesota Vikings. How did it feel to go in there into an empty Lambeau Field and get a win?
Well, you know, empty or not, you know, it's always good to get a win, you know, up at Lambeau. Especially me personally, you know, first time winning up there at Lambeau as a starter, you know, it's huge. You know, it's huge for our program. You know, we played hard, we played physical, and we just got to keep it going.
You had a bunch of hurries on Aaron Rodgers in that game. What's it like chasing down number 12?
I could tell you it's not easy. For a guy to be playing as long as he has, he still has it. You know, he still has it. You know, he's a quick guy. But, you know, it's just, you know, just everyone doing their job. You know, guys like, you know, DJ and Fadi and guys on the outside, you know, causing, you know, him to hurry up, you know, which made guys on the inside create a lot of pressure. So
it seems like you guys really picked up the intensity in the second half on the defensive side of the ball. You had big plays from Afadi Odenebo as well as DJ Wanham. What did that mean for those guys trying to establish their roles on this defense? And especially DJ, break down that last play. That was the game-stealing play.
Game-stealing play. You know, it's, you know, I'm sure you guys know a guy like Aaron Rodgers who likes to get out of the pocket and, like, throw 80-yard touchdowns. And, yep. You know, he's done that his whole career. And when you have, a young guy just – really focusing throughout the week, like DJ focusing throughout the week and just listening to what the coach was saying, you know, stay outside, don't let Aaron Rodgers get outside and throw. And, you know, he embraced that challenge, he embraced the role, and, you know, he just went out, he just did his thing. He and Afadi, you know, those guys played lights out, you know, like they do every week, you know, and, you know, that helps us as an entire defense, and it helps us, you know, as a defensive line as a whole, you know. So I'm very grateful to be playing next to those guys.
Yeah, so you talk about the young guys on this team. You were a young guy a few years ago. Now you're entering year four. No Linval Joseph, no Michael Pierce, who was supposed to be an offseason acquisition. He's sitting out for the season. So what has your new role been like this year with the Vikings? I mean, you're taking on sort of that leader. You're moving up into that leadership role.
Yeah, you know, I don't really think, you know, my role has changed much since I got here. You know, I felt like my role was just to – you know, just come in and just, you know, just work as hard as I possibly can to help our team win. You know, whether I was, you know, a rookie to a fourth-year guy, you know, I felt like it really doesn't change. You know, and, you know, that's what we take pride in as a defensive line unit. You know, just going out and just doing your job, just playing that role. You know, that's our, you know, that's what we hear from Coach Jerry every single day. You know, that's your role, go in and just do your job so the guys next to you can make a play. You know, so whether you're a rookie coming in or an older guy, you know, it's, you know, that's always been our thing as a defensive line unit.
Coach Dre, you mentioned him, and he's the leader of the defensive line unit. He gets you guys hyped up before the games, the rush man for life and all that. What has it been like kind of working with him this year, like compared to other years? Because it feels like he's more hands-on with a lot of you guys this year. He's really getting involved, trying to have you guys develop week in and week out.
Yeah, you know, like you said, you know, with him being more hands-on, you know, that allows us to, you know, be put in certain situations that can, you know, help us succeed. And, you know, it's always a pleasure working with a guy like Coach Dre, you know, a guy who's been doing this for a very long time. He knows what to do. And you know what to expect out of him, just as he knows what to expect out of his players. You know, since I've been here, everything has been, you know, it's never been any gray area. You know, you always know where you stand with Coach Dre, you know, and that's for a lot of guys, you know. So, yeah, man, we just, you know, just go out. We just take pride playing, you know, just doing the things that Coach Dre teaches us because, you know, he knows what he's doing, so.
You lost a lot of guys due to injury this year, the notable one in your group being Danielle Hunter. Yannick Ngakoue has a brief stint with you guys before getting traded to the Ravens. So it sounds like Coach Dre said Shamar Stephan has kind of picked up that leadership role. He's normally a quiet dude around the facility and stuff like that, but I think with you guys, he's definitely taken on a little bit of a leadership role.
He definitely has, you know. And it's funny because I actually noticed that, and I told him, I'm like, look, Shamar,
you've been talking a little more.
I'm saying, I'm like, bro, you're going to have to start, being that guy, bro. We look up to you, bro. You're going to have to start doing that, you know. And, I felt like, you know, Shamar has really embraced that role, you know, being the only older guy on the defensive line. He embraced that role, and, you know, I feel like everyone that's behind, we just look up to that, you know, we just follow in pursuit. You know, when a guy like that that's been playing for a couple years, for a very long time, that knows the system and that's been around the league, you know, yep. You know, why wouldn't you want to follow that, you know? And a guy that's smart as him when it comes to, like, you know, football and knowing where to go. I mean, Shamar is one of the most smartest football players I've ever met, to be honest. You know, so when you have a guy like that, you know, embracing that leadership role, you know, that motivates the younger guys.
I saw you made a bunch of plays in the run game last game against the Packers down in the backfield. Do you think that's a part of your game where you really improved the most?
I think so. You know, I think it's because, you know, just having that experience, just being in those situations, you know, every week during practice and then having it translate to the game, you know, and I think that's one thing with, you know, going back to Coach Dre, you know. Yep. He puts us in certain situations where we're able to make those kind of plays in the backfield to help our team win.
What are your expectations for the season? Ever since you've been with the Vikings, you've been on winning teams pretty much every year you've been here. So you're kind of faced with a little adversity here at 2-5, but it seems like the team could really get on a roll here.
I think so. Moving forward, you know, I ever since day one, I've always thought that we had, you know, the right guys to go out and compete and win, you know, every single week. You know, of course, you know, we got up to a slow start. But, you know, I think, again, winning at Lambeau, which is not easy to do with or without fans, you know, I think that kind of, you know, gave our team, you know, that motivation to keep going out and just, you know, keep improving all throughout the week and keep getting better. And, you know, that way on Sundays, we'll go out and we'll perform at our best.
Well, Sunday you take on the Detroit Lions at US Bank Stadium. The Vikings look to get 3-5 on the season. Thank you, Jaleel, for joining the show, and all the best for the rest of the season.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Appreciate it.